welcome. I'm Peggy. How would you like to have a birthday that you could celebrate all year long? Well, we're celebrating today, and we're celebrating the birthday of Pendleton, South Carolina. And Pendleton is 225 years old. And they have activities and events and gardens and all this year. And these very special ladies have come to invite all of us to Pendleton. And I thank you for coming, and I want to introduce everybody. Carol Burdett, and Carol is the chairperson for the whole anniversary committee. And yes, you look great. I don't know how you've held up through all of this.
I know, but at least I'm not 225 years old, but I'm getting there.
And then Davy Kirkley is here, and she is the garden lady. I'm just going to give you that title. You literally are planning all these gardens and flowers that will be available for people to see.
Correct. We're planting 225 trees and over 15,000 daffodils. So we're looking forward to spring.
Oh, well, I think we all are. Yes. And next to her is Jo McConnell, and she is a committee member, and Jo is a historian, and she conducts tours all around not only Pendleton but the surrounding area. And I thank you all for coming. Mm-hmm. I think this is so exciting. We hear a lot about Charleston and the low part of the country, which is wonderful. But sometimes we forget the gems that we have right at our own back door.
Right.
Am I right?
Absolutely.
So you've decided to make this a real event. Tell us a little bit about Pendleton.
Okay. I have to start by saying this is not my first rodeo. Back in 1990, the town of Pendleton celebrated its 200th birthday, and I had the opportunity to chair that committee. So I just got a whole new group of people, and we started a whole other year of celebrating. But Pendleton really started in 1790. April the 8th is our actual birthday, and we were founded, we were part of the Cherokee Nation. And then we were founded to be the judicial center of what was called the Pendleton District, which was what is currently today Anderson, Oconee, and Pickens counties. But before the courthouse could be finished, the legislature changed its mind. Imagine that.
No. Yes.
And they changed their mind and split the district. But Pendleton is the geographic center of the three counties, the Tri-County area. And from that time, we had people that began building their summer homes. They were coming from Charleston. We were the oldest town in the upstate. And those folks came to escape malaria, mosquitoes, the heat and the humidity,
exactly. And they came up.
And they built these beautiful homes that we still love and celebrate today. In fact, Davy lives in one of those beautiful homes that we have. And we, during this year, we thought this is a prime opportunity to celebrate our history, what's happening in the town, and the home. We look at Pendleton, it's home for many people, and we want to celebrate that.
And you have about 3,000 citizens.
Right.
And so we hope you're going to have thousands more come to visit all summer. and you've got great plans that we need. But there are many beautiful old homes and churches and buildings all around. And this, I think, is unique. The whole community is on the National Register of Historic Places. And did you not say that that's the only one in the United States where the whole town is?
It's one of the largest in the United
States. That's amazing.
And they no longer make that distinction.
Yeah.
So we were blessed that we were able to get that in 1970. And there are over 40 contributing buildings to that designation.
So that's a first, and something we can treasure here. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you can make a mini vacation. Now, there'll be places where people can have picnics.
We have a beautiful village green with trees and benches to come out and sit, and we've got the perfect walking trails. They're marked around where you can go and view the homes and the gardens and parks that we have.
So you're busy planning out, you've got a birthday party or something in June.
Absolutely. The exact birthday is April the 8th, but that is really tied into the middle of the week, and we will have just celebrated Spring Jubilee. Yeah. So we decided that we would make the official birthday party June the 6th. And we're going to have a band, we're going to have cake and ice cream and balloons, just like you'd have for a birthday party. And we want everyone that has ever been connected with Pendleton, whether living in town, going to school at Tri-County Tech, going to one of the public schools, whatever your connection, we want you to come home and enjoy cake and ice cream and music and friends.
I think that's lovely. Now, tell me about Clemson. Clemson University is tied in with Pendleton, right?
It
is. In a very special way.
It is. Joe, do you want to tell the story or you prefer?
Yeah, tell us. You're the historian. Tell us.
Well, the Pendleton Farmers Society was founded in 1815, and Thomas Greene Clemson served as its president, as did his father-in-law, John C. Calhoun. And at many of the meetings, Clemson would tell people how strongly he felt that that part of the country needed an agricultural college. So we like to say that the university was born in Pendleton because he shared that regularly with the members of his group.
So he had this dream that
he did.
We needed an agricultural college.
Right.
And out of that came Clemson University.
Absolutely. And it's interesting because when his will was read and the gift was given to the state, the legislators have to accept that gift. And the vote, it passed by one vote for them to accept his gift from his will. And so it was with great pride. He actually had outlived his family, his wife and his children. So it was a wonderful legacy for him to leave. And he and his family are buried at St. Paul's Episcopal Church, which is there in Pendleton. So his final resting place is in Pendleton.
And he was the son-in-law of
Thomas
John C. Calhoun.
That's correct.
Right? Yeah, so the whole family is right. Is very much connected.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. And so now tell us, I wanted to talk a little bit about the restaurants and the shops, and it's like a square. Or
Absolutely. Downtown is
for people who've never been there.
Right. Mm-hmm. It's a beautiful, what you think of as a beautiful southern town with a downtown square, and we have shops and restaurants that you can visit, pick up things. In fact, if I'd like to show you, we have some commemorative items that were handmade.
You want me to hold it up?
Absolutely.
So the camera can see.
Yes.
Each one, what is this? This says Pendleton, South Carolina. And what is the building that is engraved on there?
That is the Farmers Society's Farmers Hall. It is Pendleton's landmark. When you think about Pendleton, you always think about the Farmers Hall.
You got it. Okay.
And so we have the ornament. We have a lapel pin. For people that like decorative keychains, we have one of those. We have a nice necklace. And all of these can be bought at a small shop right on the town square called Mountain Maid.
So there will be, if people come, they could bring a picnic or they could eat in one of your restaurants. They can bring the whole, it's everything. What I loved when we started to talk, you said that everything you're planning is like family oriented.
Absolutely.
So people can come and bring a picnic, they can spend the day. Mm-hmm. And we're all anticipating springtime and nice weather. And that's going to make it even more special with when your flowers all start to bloom.
Absolutely. We started thinking when our planting took place that we would try to plant 225 trees. And some of the trees that we're planting are dogwoods, crepe myrtles, red maples, Yoshino cherries. We have about 12 different varieties, and we've already planted 205. So we figure by the end of the year we'll have them. And everyone just got into sponsoring daffodils, and so we've planted over 15,000, from businesses to neighborhoods to organizations that have sponsored daffodils. So come to Pendleton and see the daffodils, and we already have daffodils blooming, so hopefully they make it the next two or three days.
So you have things going on all the way up to next New Year's Eve.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we do.
A Christmas parade, and everything's tied into this.
Yes.
So if you miss one season of the year, there's something there, or you can go back.
Well, and one of the things, some of our events are things that happen annually.
Okay.
For instance, in the first weekend in April, we will be having the 38th Spring Jubilee, I believe. And Joe McConnell was the director for that festival for a number of years, and it will happen. And Joe, do you want to tell them about
it? Yeah, you're going to have certain places that people could see that ordinarily they would not. Is that right? Houses and...
Well, there's two historic homes that we have, Ashtabula and Woodburn, and they're open year-round.
Yes.
And they have special events at those locations also. They will have O Farms Days, the last Saturday in March, on the grounds of Ashtabula Plantation. And so those homes are always open. There's one or the other open every day of the week, so okay. That they're always available. Usually in the afternoons is the opening hours. And of course, a lot of the historic homes in town are private homes. So
that's
But there is a walking tour that you can take with a map that you can pick up at Hunter's Store, which is a general merchandise store right at the traffic light in town. And they will supply you with a paper pamphlet. And you can just walk through or drive through town and stop in front of these homes and learn some of the history and the people who have lived in all of those homes. And of course, the St. Paul's Church is not always open to the public, but the churchyard is. And you can walk through and see where Clemson's buried, and many other noted people are buried there in the church. So the walk is only about 1.3 miles, so it's easy. Put the kid in the stroller and take off, or you can walk. It's very easy to maneuver around, and you really get that hometown feeling because we got old-fashioned sidewalks that you can enjoy as you walk through town. It's very safe, and you just really get to absorb the atmosphere of the town by doing that.
Yeah, part of America, that sometimes we have lost some of this, but thank God we still have it in Pendleton. We'll be right back.